Hi, friend, and welcome back to Marvelous Friends, your home for all things Marvel Cinematic Universe and beyond. Today, I'm going to be talking a little bit more about the Korvac role in Captain Marvel 2. Roll that credit. In my previous video on this topic, I talked about a post provided to us on Reddit from Marvel Scoopmaster. If you have not yet seen that first video, make sure you go do that first. You can do so by clicking up on the card right here. I'll wait for you to come back. No worries. It's important. It makes everything make more sense. So just, you know, be right here when you get back. No watch, I don't know why I'm checking. So, you ready? Great. As I said in that video, it is one of two leaks dealing with the same topics of the Phase 4 villains. Now, the second leak, though, deals a little bit more specifically with just Captain Marvel and the Korvac part of that leak. Now, as always, these are leaks, and leaks are always just as trustworthy as you can throw them. And them being online and non-physical, you can't even pick them up, let alone throw them. So, take that for what you will, but as I did say in that first video, I am kind of skeptical on that first portion of the leak. Why then, if I'm so critical of that first leak, am I talking about the second leak that's a direct follow-up to the first? Well, first and foremost, I need video content for a channel, but it's also mainly because this second leak delves much more into the part of the first that I actually agree with. That part being that Korvac will play a major role in Captain Marvel's second installment of her franchise. And I think this would work really well for this film, as long as we do a little bit of tweaking to the character Korvac himself. Let's start at the beginning then and explain who Korvac is. As I said in that previous video, he may not be a character that everyone immediately recognizes. His full name is Michael Korvac, and he does come from Earth. Just not our Earth. Korvac comes from Earth 691, and it's safe to say that the Marvel Cinematic Universe is firmly planted on Earth 616, which is basically our normal reality, just with superheroes. I really should do a video on explaining the comic multiverse. Eventually. Basically, what you need to know about Earth 691 is in this reality, humans live on the moon, and Korvac comes from an area on the moon called the Blue Area. Now, Korvac eventually turns against humanity when they are being invaded by the alien race known as the Badoon. After siding with the Badoon, who are a cybernetic alien kind of robotic race, they decide to conduct experiments on him, these experiments giving him cybernetic implants and therefore superhuman abilities. Being recognized for his powers, he is then recruited by the Grand Master, the Grand Master teleporting him through time and space to his dimension. Although he does this to use Korvac in a pawn in his games. The Grandmaster put Korvac against the Defenders and Doctor Strange, as well as other combinations of heroes over the years. Korvac, however, was repeatedly defeated in these battles. Korvac doing this on purpose as a plan to get closer to the Grand Master, which actually succeeds with the Grand Master taking him in under his wing. During this process, Korvac is able to analyze the Grand Master and assess his abilities much closer. Then by using his cybernetic implants, he is able to copy those powers that Grand Master has, only enhancing his own abilities. Eventually being able to break free from Grand Master's control, he escapes to seek revenge on the Badoon, eventually wiping out the alien race altogether. He is eventually stopped and taken down by Thor and the Guardians of the Galaxy, who work together to do so. Now, I will go ahead and state it right now, at this point, before I start getting comments about it, I do not think that we'll be seeing the Grandmaster play a major role in the plot of Captain Marvel 2. However, this would be a potential way to make the first portion of the leak set come true if the Grandmaster does recruit him after being taken down by Captain Marvel, which I will get to in a second on how that would work, and then kind of using him against other heroes. This would be kind of an interesting thing, but again, I don't see this being something in the major plot points of the movie. This could potentially be like a post-credit scene as we see Korvac teleported away and appearing before Grandmaster. I did mention this in my 10 villains I would like to see in the MCU moving forward video, that I would like to see the Grandmaster and or Arcade pop up. Again, kind of I felt like he wasn't quite used to his full potential, because the Grandmaster actually is a pretty strong villain, and we didn't really get to see all of that play out, really, in the Thor Ragnarok story, as Hela really was our supercharged main villain of that movie. So I would like to kind of maybe see a nod to this part of the story, but I don't think we're going to have Grandmaster playing a major role. I do have to kind of point out the slight issue that Korvac isn't technically in our universe, but that's pretty much an easy fix, as they could just replace him to be kind of an origin story here in our own Earth 616. Or if the whole multiverse theory does pan out in the stories of Mysterio and Spider-Man in Far From Home, that could kind of play up and add into that storyline of developing that multiverse. Now, I would say, though, that our major here issue is going to become the fact that the Badoon do not exist currently in our franchises, and so the best way for him to work in this film is for him to be a kind of a tool of the Kree instead, with them developing the experiments and creating Korvac as a weapon for themselves. Now, the Supreme Intelligence does allude to the fact that they created Captain Marvel and gave her her powers, and we see that Carol accepts this without any argument, which is kind of not her style in the movie. She does question things quite often, but she doesn't question this. It could be potentially because she has seen them experiment and create super soldiers of their own kind in some way, and so she probably just believed this. However, her just being kind of an exceptionally strong version of these, that they may not be able to quite understand how that was possible. I also do want to kind of point out here that we saw many of the Kree that were in Captain Marvel's kind of group at the beginning of it using very highly advanced weaponry. Now, these were all seem to be very customized to the individual soldier and used kind of as an extension of their own abilities, kind of, again, playing into the fact that Kree has done these kind of experiments on their soldiers to enhance them in some ways. So that could be why she accepts this as an option when they're controlling her, and it would make sense then that they potentially have the ability to create a Korvac within their technology set. Now, going back to what this plot and this character's story would look like in the Captain Marvel 2 movie, we would now see that Captain Marvel has going about the process to destroy a super weapon that she has heard about, perhaps not knowing that it's another person and just thinking that it's an actual physical weapon, one that she's heard about because the Kree have created this to replace the fact that they were not able to get the weapon that Mar-Vell created, which turned out to be Carol herself, so them needing something to replace that superpower. Now, when she arrives to destroy it, she would then go up against Korvac, not really realizing at first that he is the actual weapon and perhaps just a guard to kind of keep it safe. During this fight, though, as she tries to get past him, realizing that he is actually very supercharged himself, and eventually that realization comes to be that he, like herself, is actually the weapon. His powers perhaps being able to match hers in some way, maybe using the knowledge they know of Carol's own powers, being able to create something that kind of counterbalances it, counteracts her phase blasts or something along the line, and then of course him having some level of super strength of his own. So I think that would be really interesting to see his power set kind of manipulated to be something kind of like the anti-Carol and anti-Captain Marvel. And that would make sense then as well that, you know, the Kree want to create a super weapon that is specifically made to kind of protect them from Captain Marvel, as she so easily wiped through their armada when Ronan kind of arrived at Earth. I'm going to put a little bit of a caveat on this, as we as the audience will really need some kind of explanation to show how this has been done. Currently, the Kree don't have the technology to take on Carol, as we saw, again, her blow through that armada so easily. So their technology and their power is just not on a level to take on Carol, so we'll need some kind of explanation for this. On top of that, their main source of kind of leadership and the supercomputer that runs them, the Supreme Intelligence, has been taken down by Carol, most likely throwing them into some kind of state of chaos. So for them to have developed a super weapon during all that means something has to have gone on, and we'll need that backstory. Perhaps getting this kind of the same way we got the initial flashes at the beginning of Captain Marvel 1, where we kind of start at that, we learn about them building the weapon, and then we go back to Carol with the Skrull as they go on this journey to find them the new homeworld, this chaos allowing her time to do so and kind of getting them safely placed and then going back out after the cream. Now, moving back to her interaction with Korvac, I think during their battle, eventually she will realize what's going on and kind of let off and convince him that she is not his enemy. In that process, explaining to him that the Kree are not a good people and that he should not be siding with them. I will also state here that I won't think that in this readaptation, that Korvac is going to be a human. I predict that he will actually be a Kree citizen that maybe volunteered for this, or most likely was taken to be made this weapon. Moving on from here, though, he will kind of decide to side with Carol as they either go after the Kree as a pair, or perhaps go through the process of discovering what was done to him to make him the weapon. Carol wanting to be able to prevent future weapons from being made, while also convincing Korvac to go against the Kree and work with her. However, I think something in this process eventually will set Korvac to the extreme, learning something that they did to him was kind of very inhuman and very devastating to him. Perhaps when he was taken, killing his family to force him to do this, who knows? So I think that will, though, kind of set him on that final tipping point to go after the Kree at full force, wanting to destroy them, much like he destroys the Badoon in the comic books. Now, Carol, of course, not wanting to really destroy the Kree, just stop the conflict, will then go after him to kind of prevent this decimation of an entire people, as that's not her end goal. This then, of course, would result in their final face-off against one another, with them going at each other with the full extent of their powers. Once again, this is where I'm going to start kind of picking apart this leak and disagreeing with some of the little finer details. Again, this points that Korvac will pop up again in the Guardians and the Internals. I don't really see this as happening unless it's like a kind of post-credit scene in the Internals, because again, the Guardians has enough going on, the Internals have enough going on. Really, as far as the Guardians go, I don't see it being a post-credit scene. If anything, maybe much like the Guardians Volume 2, where we had the opening scene where they're battling the space worms and protecting the batteries, maybe they're fighting off Korvac during this. But that's really the only way this will work. But again, this doesn't make him a major player in that overarching kind of franchise of the cosmic side of the MCU Phase 4. This is going to be something that I'm going to point out as being a little bit more of a convenience and maybe playing up on the fact that we did see Thor heading out with the Guardians at the end of Endgame. Something that really hasn't been spoken to Thor's involvement with everything we've learned about or been kind of rumored and leaked about regarding that movie. So with the exception of the recent kind of use of the "who's in charge, I'm in charge" clip from the end of Endgame when Thor joins the Guardians, we really haven't gotten a lot of information or kind of teasing about Thor's involvement with that film. So I think this is a little bit more of kind of a convenience and kind of playing up on the fact that in the comics, Korvac is taken down by this grouping, and knowing that they kind of left Earth at the end of it, we don't necessarily know that they're going to stay together moving forward. This source also points to the fact that there will be a romantic relationship between Korvac and Carol. I do not buy this. The first film was just fine without a romantic story, and Carol kind of being this power woman in her franchise, I think a kind of typical love story is not going to be something that we see in her films. And I don't really think it's necessary for her films. I think that kind of adds a little bit of an unnecessary story element to her focus of solving this kind of Kree-Skrull conflict. On top of that, I will say that I think that Carol is the one of the potential characters that Marvel Studios is pointing at as the character that is going to be coming out soonish as their gay character, just because Carol is very typically part of the LGBT community in the comics, and I am personally very team Carol and Valkyrie moving forward in the MCU. Now, her coming out could happen in this movie. I don't think it will. It will probably be something later on, but again, I don't think it's necessary for the character to be out or anything like that. But that's just me. I think more so what's going to happen here and what's going to call her off rather than romantic feelings is the fact of just her humanity. She doesn't really want to destroy and kill everything. That's why she's going to go try to stop Korvac from killing the Kree. The same thing, she will do whatever she can to stop him, but she doesn't want to actually kill him, as her goal is to save life, not destroy it. Personally, I don't think Carol, again, needs a romantic interest, but I do think she needs a pivot point for this conflict. So I think Korvac could provide that really well as him being kind of the the focal point within the Kree and Skrull war that we see play out in this film. I think this would make for a really good villain, and he would play really well into this. I could see him potentially being used again later on, maybe, as he does have interactions with other characters. But I think for Phase 4, he will be limited to just the Captain Marvel 2 movie. But what do you think? Do you like Korvac? Did you know who Korvac was before these leaks? And do you want to see him be a part of the Kree-Skrull War? Let me know all of that down in the comments. I, of course, will always be talking about this more as we learn more from both leaks, rumors, anything that seems credible, and of course, Marvel Studios itself. So make sure you subscribe and set those alerts because you don't want to miss a thing. And again, we are heading into the head of the whole Comic-Con season, so we're definitely probably going to get some more information, especially with these films that are most likely going to be towards the front of Phase 4. Until then, though, I love you all 3,000. I hope you have a marvelous rest of your day. Bye, friend.